So our next presenter is visiting from Indonesia, from the University of Kajamato, which is about an hour away from Jakarta, the capital of Indonesia, Dr. Doni. He's a neuro-ophthalmologist there at the University of Kajamato. And he's going to be presenting on a project that has interested him because he's particularly interested in medical education and outreach. So this is a project where he went out and met with local farmers to educate them about pesticide use and the ocular disorders that are encountered with certain pesticide use. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Doni. Actually, it's weird because in Indonesia, it's common. People have a single name. So my name is Widyandana. But you can call me Doni. That's my nickname. I come from Indonesia. This is our study and our services in the community. So it's about pesticide exposure and ocular disorder in Ngablak village, Central Java, Indonesia. So I come from Indonesia. It's a 29 hours flight with for transit, so it's quite far from Utah. This is the situation in Ngablak village. It's very nice village in the highland. So the weather is nice. It's not so cold like here. We have no snow in Indonesia. So still, people have vegetables, they plant vegetables and also tobacco in this village. So most of them are farmer. They work as a farmer, and this farmer have habits that really make us care about their healthy status. It's about using pesticide without protection. So they're unprotected because they have lack of safety equipment. There is no Google. There is no idea how to protect themselves in the field. And they use semi-modern tools. So they have mechanical spray tools to use to spray this pesticide to the plants. And they consider about the cost also because it's quite expensive to buy a Google hand gloves and the coat for the protection. So this is why we think this farmer never use that kind of protection when spraying the pesticide. If we read the literature, we can see that ideally they use this kind of protection. But usually our farmer, they only see the wind. So when they saw that the wind direction is go that way, they spray this way. So it's very traditional, but they use that kind of technique almost every day in that village. We can see that the pesticide is actually able to penetrate our body through the skins, and this is the area that really bad influenced by this pesticide. Especially in the genital area is 100% penetrated, which is very dangerous in this area and also in this area in the head. So this is the reality in Ngablak village. They use this kind of protection. It's only for the sun. They're not even thinking that it's also protection for the pesticide, but they use it for the sun. But actually, the ideal protection should be like this. So the danger of pesticide, it can penetrate from the skin, the eyes, inhalation, and ingestion. If you saw the publication before, they said that they had effect of the pesticide. It can be depression, neurological deficit, diabetes, respiratory disease, and also cancer. So we formed a team to go to this village. So in this Ngablak project, actually it's a multi-years project, you know, starting this project. It's combined research and health services to the community. And the aim of this project to educate farmers protecting themselves when using pesticide, to collect the data about neuro-ophthalmological disorders and possibly image related to this pesticide exposure. So the team consists of the dermatologists, neurologists, and also ophthalmologists for this first year. The methods, we give training to the cadre and the communities, conducting a field observation, giving free personal protective equipment and eyeglass, and also free medical exam and medicine, and also free cataract and pterygium surgery. So we take the data from this free medical exam. The participant for our first medical exam, we have like 280 person visit our camps, and we have 164 male and 117 female farmer, and we have this the age most of them between 18 to 16 years old, and some of them above 60, and just only minor number for below 18. For the vital sign in the general examination is normal, most of them. Sorry. For the past medical history, we got that, but not many of them filled the questionnaire, so we only have this kind of data that some of them have hypercholesterol, some of them have diabetes, and some of them have hypertension according their answer in the questionnaire. But only one person, two person had this kind of heart attack, cancer, stroke, head trauma, and also cerebral infection. For the habits, we see that this smoking habit only minor number fill the questionnaire, but I'm sure that some of them have this habit. And coffee, drinking coffee, some of them, most of them have this habit. Analgesic use and also other medication. For the peripheral blood test that we got from the data until now, we see that from this result that 20 of them have abnormal blood glucose, uric acid. You can see that is quite a big number, and cholesterol also 37 the number of the patient that have this cholesterol high. So about the exposure itself, we can see that most of them using this pesticide one or twice per week, and some of them more than twice, some of them less than once. For the onset using this pesticide, you can see that more than 10 years, most of them. So 88 farmer use this pesticide, spray with that kind of unprotected equipment is more than 10 years, is 88 farmer. And some of them is below 5 years, then you can see this data. So it's quite long exposure. So this is the pesticide they have in general. And we can see from this pesticide, and we see the ingredients and the content. And the demolish is the most dangerous, I think. It's called abamectin, 18 gram per liter. It's adequate evidence of clinical sign of central nervous system toxicity. So this agent is very dangerous, but the other is not so dangerous. From the eye examination, you can see the data below about the palpebra, conjunctiva, cornea, camera oculi anterior, iris, RAPD, and vitreous that we saw from this patient. That we saw that less than 1% eye abnormality occurred from this patient. So it's not big number, but we are not sure actually. We would like to gain more data about this. Yes.
Were these all abnormalities or abnormalities that you thought were related to exposure?
Yeah, it's all abnormal. So it's still raw data. Yeah. So we will see again the exposure, be related with the exposure or not. So we not still not sure about this. Yeah. But the facial acuity, some of them have problem with the facial acuity, but actually this number actually because the elderly people, so they need a reading glass. And the lenses, you see, this is 7.2% abnormality, and this one is for the refractive error actually. So because this team is not all of them is ophthalmology, so they write like this. For the ECRA and contrast examination, we can see that 1.6 abnormality for the ECRA and around 9.4 abnormality for the contrast test. For the eye disease that we can diagnose from this patient, we can see that we get 7 cataract. In that moment, then we already give like a social program for this cataract surgery. We have 1 conjunctivitis, 1 exotropia, so it's small number, 1 glaucoma, 1 hypertension, retinopathy, and strange as well is mean that refractive error. Pterygium, we got 2 patients, and this is will be 2 patients, suspect high myope, 1 patient. So it's actually this number is not so high. So you can see that in the literature that long-term ocular exposure to pesticide it can affect the conjunctiva, cornea, iris, lens, retina, and the optic nerve itself. So the Gajamada initiative now we try to implement this project. It's actually a 3-year project. We implement this research. We develop this flip chart. We give them protection for the community. We try to educate people that it's dangerous to use this pesticide without protection. We try to get some cheap protection for them, for example, this boot and face mask and also Google. And also they can use actually raincoat to protect themselves. The raincoat is not so expensive actually. Thank you very much. This is my presentation. Please.